This is important, dear one, for it is time for humanity to step back into the creative process. For no longer are we babes within the field, but instead we have become the farmer who will grow life, who will influence the change of seasons within the course of their own lifetime, to bring about the desired outcome of the global human experience. And yes, dear ones, this will filter down into the scientific scale, to where we understand that the consciousness is what has been factored out, and it is that consciousness that must be restored to give the final answer to the creative science called quantum physics. This is important, dear one, for after all, we are only studying ourself. But as long as we believe ourself to be separate from the field of science and from the material world, there will always be something missing. There will always be unanswered questions. And so, dear ones, look. Look and see how you define that which you call God. Look and see how you believe God to be separate from the creative process, from the experience on earth, and from your own personal life. And then, dear one, you will see how you have taken some part of your own self out of the experience of life, believing that you cannot in fact change and alter the course of your experience, believing that you cannot change and alter the course of the human reality that is currently being accepted as life within this world. So, dear ones, what is it that you call God? And what is it that you believe is missing? For when you answer these questions within yourself, you will come to a deeper understanding about who you are, about how you define yourself in this material world. Understand, dear ones, that by looking through the lens of your mind, you are only giving yourself a very simplistic view of this world, a very limited understanding of that which the world truly is. For humanity is currently growing and outgrowing the limited concepts within their mind until they, dear ones, are ready to embrace the greater whole that they are. This includes the limited field of the mind, but more importantly, the greater field of human consciousness, the greater intelligence, the greater awareness. And so, dear ones, this may be an uncomfortable process of letting go of the limitations that you find within yourself upon closer self-examination, for you have often held on to beliefs of truth within you, and they have sculpted how you see and how you interact with the world around you. But, dear ones, continue to look, continue to ask, and you will find the answer within yourself. It will come from a place deeper than your own observational mind. It will come from a place deeper than your own analytical thinking. It will come, dear one, from a center of knowledge within your own heart. A knowledge that is felt as truth. A knowledge that is known as truth. A knowledge that cannot be dismissed from your own personal experience. And this, dear one, will give you something to compare your mind to. A superficial thought within your mind compared to a deep, heartfelt knowing. And then, dear ones, you'll be faced with the question of what truth to trust. The truth of a socially conditioned mind based upon concepts of limitation, based upon concepts of separation, based upon the belief that God is not present within your world, and that if only you could find God, if only you could identify God, it will solve all your problems and suffering. Compared, dear one, to the knowing within your heart that all is God, that nothing is missing when you choose to put yourself back into life, when you choose to honor the deeper intelligence within your heart and create your life based upon your own heart's desires, no longer living based upon expectations and social conditioning, based upon judgments and limiting concepts within your mind. And so, dear ones, what is separate from God? Why is God missing? And why? Why are you unable to allow yourself to see God in every particle of reality, in every speck of matter, in the twinkle in every person's eye, and in the warmth of every human heart? So, dear ones, ask yourself, what is it that you are looking for? Ask yourself, what is it that is missing? And then, dear ones, start to live more fully from your own heart, and you will understand that God has never left, that God always is, that it was simply you that took yourself out of the equation, that it was you were looking for the entire time. Many blessings, dear ones. Much love, and namaste.